Hello, my name is Sheikh Fabi. I welcome you to another edition of our GIS lectures. Today we continue on working with images in ArcGIS, but today we want to look at digital elevation models, how to construct digital elevation models from point data. I know, I'm aware that there are so many free source, open source elevation model in the on the internet. Some of them, we have the SRTM, we have ASTA, and we have some other models, but most of them are at a very low resolution. But some of them are about 30 meter resolution, some of them are about 90 meter resolution. But when we want to cut and fill, or when you want to be involved in engineering purposes, when you need the height elevation model for engineering purposes, for building construction, from road construction, from dam vision and things like that, you need a more detailed, a densely generated point. So we are going to look at how we can, so you may need to develop the location specific one. So you may need something like a more high frequency GPS that can help you to get the location. So we have some data that we are going to use to demonstrate how you can use from a project, how you can use data. So we have this data that we have for the entire country, and just a GPS location of points all over the country. And this data we are going to use to generate detailed elevation model. We have different model. It's a model because we are just trying to estimate based on certain parameters. And we have the Kriging method that we use at different purposes. So we are going to do two options. Option one is to do it for the entire country. Option two is to do it for Oyo State. We use Oyo State to carve out the population that the to carve out the point that fall within Oyo State, and we can use Oyo State to, as a boundary of our elevation model. So you can go to the search, and under this search, you come to, we are going to use IDW option, and we look at the input. The input is GPS point national. The value is when we look at the value, let's go and look at the value of this point, the point data that we have the values. These are the values in meters, and you can see the X and Y coordinate. If you get your GPS point and you load your GPS point directly into your GIS, ArcGIS, it will give you the location, the X and Y coordinates, as well as the Z value, which is the value we are going to use for our data elevation model. So we go to search. Search can help you to see the option you want to use. And we are going to use IDW, as I said earlier, and we are going to put input is the GPS coordinate, the Z value, which is the height, is going to be the value which I showed you earlier on. Then the output raster, where do we want to put the output? The output, we are going to put the output in this as Nigeria raster. Let's just give it the name or elevation, DEM, data elevation model. Some people call it data terrain model. And then we are going to use number of points. We are going to use 12 points to compute the location of a particular area. Then in this case, that we are not going to put barrier because we don't have a specific barrier for this. So we click OK. I'm going to take some time. It's working here. Can see it's working somewhere in this area. So we have your, you have the, we have the it's working, and when it finishes, can see the elevation model have been generated, and the elevation model is now a raster data. It's a raster data, and you can see that it shows different elevation. You can see the height, the area that are higher, the area around just is higher, area around look at the map and look at the let's make it hollow so that we see the different the states that are there that are higher, because the brighter color, you can see the elevation here, the brighter colors are the higher elevation, while the lower colors are the deeper colors are the lower elevation. So you can see in meters, you can see the area that are higher and the area that are lower. Want to make it hollow? Let's make this this hollow so that we can have and we can label. You see that the area that are higher elevation are around Jos. Let's label the states. Kaduna, Bauchi, Jos, they are very, very, very high. And you can see the area around Adamawa, Taraba, around the Cameroon Highlands. See the area are higher, and you can see that the Niger, River Niger and River Benue Basin, they are low. They are low generally. And you can see some part of the southern part of Nigeria, they are low elevation-wise. Now we want to look at this, want to carve out only, want to use this space as our boundary, or your state as our boundary. We have carved out or your state out of it. The procedure of getting your state out of this have shown us before, and we can use number. There are two ways. We can recompute our elevation model using the procedure and using the boundary, using your state as our boundary, or we use your state boundary to clip the data elevation model. We are going to use the first option. Remember, if you want to get clip, you can go to the you can go to the search and you clip, and clip will give us the data management clip, and our raster data is the elevation model we have just computed. That's Nigerian DEM. So we want to carve out, want to use Oyo State as the boundary input to cut this out, to cut it out. And then you can click OK. It's going to take some time. It's doing the something. The other alternative is to extract the point that fall within Oyo State, and then you compute your data elevation model and use the boundary, use the state or your state as the boundary of that. You can, this is what this one has given us. You can see the state boundary. You can see the data elevation model for Oyo State, and you can do a lot of things with the data set. If you want to do change analysis, you want to do cut and fill, you can see what we have in Oyo State. The other alternative is to extract the point we have in Oyo State and use the data to elevate. So what we can do is that we go to clip, but this time around we are clipping the you use the clip for factor data. The other clip, this clip is for the raster using a factor. But this time around, this one is clip of factor by factor. So we are going to use This clip input feature is going to be the point national, and the output clip is the Oyo state. Here we are cutting, we are want to cut the point that fall within Oyo state using this clip method, and then we want to put it in this one as a Oyo elevation, and we are done. And then you click this one, we extract for us all the points that fall within Oyo state. You can see this, so you can go back to the surface interpolation. Surface interpolation. Once you click there, surface, sorry, surface interpolation. So we come over to IDW. And here you click on your elevation, the value is the same, and then we want to put it as on your dem, or your dem, and now you want to provide a boundary that input barrier polyline feature. So in this case now I want to put on your 32, want to put on your our data, Georgia is in where is the boundary? Look for the boundary in E. Cannot find the data again. Let me see. Okay, so we cannot find the boundary I want to use as limiting now. So we just click OK, and it's going to give us. It's already working, and has given us, if you have the boundary, it's going to cut this one out like this, and you can see this one is far better than the other one because it's limited, it's not, it's using interpolation, and this one is far better than this, and you can see that the elevation that has been interpolated is this 33 meters. This is 33 meters. Okay, where are we? So your dem. So can see. Okay, value. Value is not 33. So that is how you can. How you can get do a digital elevation model. You have converted to raster from vector data. Thank you for listening. Please, you can subscribe to our channel so that we can update you with our new edition.